learning about electric power through circuit elements. So you can see on the left here we have an element. It has two terminals and we have a voltage over it. So this is a voltage over the element. And we have a current defined into it, so into the positive terminal. And so this is actually, when we define the current into the positive terminal, we call this a passive element. And this has to just do the way we define it. Note that this current can technically be negative, but just the way normally operating, it would be a positive one. So we have a passive element here. If we want to know the power absorbed by this, we need the electric power equation. That equation is P, the power, equals the current times the voltage. And note that these are lowercase values, so this can be changing over time. This equation is still true. This is a definition. And so if we want to know the power through an element, say it's a resistor, if we know the voltage and the current, we multiply those together and we will get power. The unit for power is going to be watts. And we just put a W and that equals joules per second. So make sure to write your units. And because it's a passive element, we would say that this is the amount of power being absorbed by this element. So I'm going to write that down here. We can also have power generated by a device or an element. So I'm just going to draw this again over here. We still have the positive and negative, so we're defining V over it. But if we define the current out of the device, this would be an active device or element. And so we would generally say that this is producing power. So if it's producing positive power, then it, or generating power, current is going out of it, and then the voltage is the same polarity. So this would be supplying or producing. So we can say for any element, both passive and active, that the power is going to be equal to the voltage times the current, and that's going to be measured in watts. And for a passive element, it will be absorbing power because current will be going into the positive node. And the inactive element would be supplying power, and that's the current will be coming out of that node. So that's electric power.